When DNA polymerase replicates DNA, it uses proofreading functions to prevent the misincorporation of bases. However, DNA polymerase does incorporate an incorrect base for approximately 1 in 1,000,000 bases synthesized, resulting in a mismatch that distorts the structure of the double helix. Curiously, far fewer than 1 in 10^6 mutations actually arise. The mutation rate in an E. coli cell is only 1 for every 10^9 or 10^10 bases replicated. The cell has a number of repair methods, including one called methyl mismatch repair to remove and replace a mismatched base. Methyl mismatch repair involves recognition of the methylation pattern in DNA bases. E. coli methylates its DNA at the palindromic sequence GATC using an enzyme called deoxyadenosine methylase, or DAM methylase. DAM methylase adds a methyl group to the adenine in both strands of the sequence. Adenine and thymine bases pair normally. The DAM methylase acts soon, but not immediately, after replication of a DNA sequence. Where DNA has methylation sequences, the parental strand will be methylated, but the new strand will still be unmethylated. The difference in methylation allows the cell to distinguish the correct sequence, presumably on the parental strand, from the incorrect sequence on the new strand. A series of proteins called MUTE-S, MUTE-L, and MUTE-H act together to repair the mismatch. MUTE-S first binds to the mismatch and recruits MUTE-L and MUTE-H. MUTE-L recognizes the methylated strand and brings it in a loop. MUTE-H then cleaves the unmethylated strand containing the mutation near the GATC. A DNA helicase called UVRD then unwinds the cleaved strand, exposing it to a variety of exonucleases. The result is a gap that is filled in by DNA polymerase 1. The DNA polymerase continues through the region that originally contained the mismatch, inserting a correct nucleotide this time. After a while, the DNA polymerase falls off the DNA, and the gap that remains is sealed by DNA ligase. The methyl-directed mismatch repair proteins and genes are called MUTE because strains that are defective in one of these proteins have a high mutation rate. A bacterial strain with a high mutation rate is called a mutator strain.